would just like to come and be an observer at one of those meetings if that's possible, because I don't know how all those people can actually contribute and participate in those meetings. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you. I have to say, a lot of what you've just said there was the end of green, but I would also like to be included in our meeting. Wendy?
Sorry, would you like me just to respond to that, if I may? Councillor, thank you. We will come back here when you want us to come back. We recognise that we have not met your expectations tonight, and we are happy to do that and come back with some fuller paper to you and explain that to you. The important thing for me is that the integration of services locally is something that is going to be designed locally by our colleagues around the table here and with our officer colleagues from the local authority, and they are now working on that to come up with a proposal and some options for how best that might be done. And that's the important thing for you, is to know locally how that will work. We are, as a partnership, trying to spread practice from elsewhere where it seems to have worked, where we think we can get some fast traction to make those sorts of changes that you were talking about. We've all experienced that, where, you know, it's our lover, brother, neighbour who has experienced those, where there have been handoffs or people sent home without packages wrapped around them, without appropriate district nursing support going behind them. We need to change that, and those plans can and are in the process now of being designed locally. We will support that, but I know our colleagues around the table here, including local authority officers, will be coming back with those thoughts about how that is best done locally. We're
at your
disposal.
Can I just
recommend
on that, please?
Okay, that's really helpful, legal. So there's a map presented before by Mel, and that's a local map that we've developed, and that was about the 9 neighbourhoods of Wirral, with an aim to wrap around how health professionals, social care professionals, could work around primary care people in those communities. You'll recall the last scrutiny committee where we had a presentation from Wirral Community Foundation Trust and from Social Care, and that was a joint presentation to say how we've integrated those local teams in order to deliver services that enable people to tell their story only once and to be able to have the right care in the right place at the right time. So progress in terms of integration is going to be pacing. And I think the point that's being made today is very much that Wirral needs to get on with that. SGP's not going to get in the way of any of that. You know, Andrew and the team are about the specialised services that happen on a larger remit. So those issues around Wirral basis will always come here and will always be discussed here. They go to the Cabinet for decisions. In the future, they'll go through our Integrated Commissioner. Again, we've had presentations here about how the Integrated Commissioner is going to work. And for those services more specialised, like if there's learning disabilities and mental health problems, again, the plan later in the summer is to integrate the services of Cheshire Rural Partnership Trust alongside social care as well. Now, those changes are part of the plan, footsteps along the way, but it's really important for them to recognise that this is something that is ongoing in Wirral and will continue to be taken forward.
Thanks, Chair. I'll try to be brief. First thing to say is that I want to appreciate our NHS and all the fantastic work that goes on in it. It's a personal experience having broken my wrist in the autumn. Care I had in A&E, at the fracture clinic, and now with the physios is absolutely fantastic. And I think, while there's stuff to do, and I think you've said that, and we know that, I want to appreciate the fact of how many good things there are, how many hard working staff there are in our NHS. I was really interested to read a report by the King's Fund around some of the changes that are going on in health and plans and so on. And their comment was, operational pressures cannot be managed by simply working harder. They require the development of new care models to meet the rising demand for care in the community as well as in hospitals. And then they commented that one of the barriers to that could be frictions between organisations that are used to competing. And I just wondered if you could give us a flavour for how the working together is going and and whether you're managing to draw all the colleagues along, together.
I mean, I don't know if Dave wants to comment as well from a provider perspective, but I think the relationships across Wirral amongst providers and commissioners have gone on leaps and bounds in the last year or so. I think, as I referred to earlier, the decision of the council around integrating health and care with the community trust was all brave and right. We already have a number of sessions where we get together and have discussions about where the opportunities are in delivering healthy Wirral. There's certainly been work around diabetes, respiratory services, some things about improving the delivery and pathways. Even when we face problems, and I think Councillor McLaughlin referred to phlebotomy earlier, that's been about a discussion about what's the best thing we can do next. So when we recognise we have an issue, and again, you know, I referred earlier to psychological therapies, the important thing for us now is getting it right. What we've done in the past is going to situations where we've almost created problems of our own making, like phlebotomy, like psychological therapies, without thinking them through, without actually having that level of consultation, and that has to be different. And you know, when I, that's the conversations I've had with the chair and others within the committee. So we are building slowly and we're building that trust of working together. We have a number of, currently, for example, on referral to treatment times, we've got a group of across the system looking at how we can do that better. So they're really, I'm just going over to Dave now, actually, I'd say what you would need.
I think the partnership working across all organisations in the world at this moment in time that is strongest, recognising the challenges that strength lies in our collaboration and working together for what we want is the best offer and outcome for our residents and patients on the world and beyond. We've got some fantastic examples where our teams together now are working closer together, whether it's community physiotherapy with acute physiotherapy, triaging for MSK, to make sure that we can point the patient in the right direction as fast as possible to get the best care as closest to home. Clearly there's more that we can do, and part of today's presentation around how we can deliver that change at a greater pace, but again the same emphasis around the outcomes for our patients being at the centre of what we want to do. So there's some real strong working at the moment, and we'll continue to do that both within the world and across the world as well, as we undoubtedly need to deliver what is one of the biggest challenges, not only around the finances, but how we use the workforce better across the NHS.
So strong partnerships doesn't mean we always agree, but it means working through the problem. And it means working through the problem with the need to deliver better care and better health for rural residents, about doing it in a way that actually makes sense for people who are recipients of care and the people working in care. So you've heard us talk here before about the urgent care issue. We came to you last summer with the performance in not a very good place. I think we were 138th in the country, something like that.
Yeah.
We're now in the other week we were 11th, I think, in the country. But that's come through working together. It's about recognising this is, you know, accident and emergency performance is not an issue for the accident and emergency department. Nor is it an issue for the hospital, so it's an issue for our system. It's a barometer of how our system operates. Because around that you have things like domiciliary care, you have care home placements, you have lots of other things, lots of other moving parts. And what we've done by working with the community trust, social care, the hospital trust, and indeed general practice and CWP as the mental Cheshire Partnerships as the mental health provider, is bring those moving parts into a level of alignment, where actually we are making some really, really fundamental changes, which, you know, scrutiny committee are aware of, and I think we've got a session with you and Cheshire and Wirral colleagues next week, well, I'm on leave, to go through a bit more, which is subject to that to pre-consultation work.
Thank you. It's interesting when you talk about patients. It'll be interesting to see what, because I see them as people rather than patients. I think within the NHS, I think you're very patient focused, rather than use the human rights based approach, which is about the person. So it will be interesting to see what people on the world think. I have Paul next, And then we have David. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Chair. As a councillor, one of the things you were here to do is to represent the people that are your electors. And constantly I receive emails and phone calls and people at great length asking me what's happening with our NHS. And no doubt I'll have conversations with people over the next couple of days who will ask me what was the meeting all about tonight. To be honest, I'm not really sure what I would tell them. What I do know is I spent 3 weeks over the last 2 months in hospital watching my brother die, listening to ambulance drivers, looking at the chaos that exists in the NHS and seeing good doctors and nurses who are just overstretched. And when you ask us to accept that there's a lack of resources, ask us to accept the need for change, I don't think any of us on this side of the room will accept the need for change without a conversation, but will accept the lack of resources in the NHS. I take on board the fact that you're saying that, you know, you won't be involved in wholesale privatisation of the NHS, but what you don't seem to understand is that it's the piecemeal privatisation of the NHS that we have concerns about. And when you come to meetings and you've spoken to, you know, leave it to us, we're the experts, or leave it to us, we're the clinicians, we'll make decisions about these things, and then you'll find out about it later. Because that's how we feel. And, you know, when we represent an electorate who are concerned about privatisation, who are concerned about lack of resources, we don't accept it, we won't accept it. So I'm sorry, you'll probably always receive some sort of a hard ride from us. And we accept the fact that it's not the staff's fault. You know, the dedicated nurses and doctors that we all come across. But the reality is, we won't accept the situation we're in, and we will continue to fight to get an NHS that our residents deserve and need.
you'd be familiar with the difference between a CT scan and an MRI scan. At the moment, we don't have the capability to provide the same level of MRI scans across Cheshire and Merseyside because there aren't enough radiographers to do that. Just aren't. Now, if you happen to have a need for an MRI scan at 4 a.m. in the morning, and you happen to be near a hospital that has sufficient radiographers to be able to perform that, then you will be able to have one. If you don't, you may have to transfer to another hospital. It could be some significant distance away. If you actually look at the number of radiographers across Cheshire and Merseyside who have the skills and capabilities, and you create a central team that actually then is able to go to whichever hospital the patient is in to perform an MRI scan, the patient remains where they are in their host hospital. They get the scan. The determination then of what needs to happen to them next can be enabled. And they don't have to go in an ambulance to another hospital or a specialist centre. And that's about using skills, capabilities and the resource of the workforce that we have across Cheshire and Mersey in a different way.
So, in essence, though I'm not saying I'm necessarily against that checklist, but the answer is yes.
The answer to the question of will staff move to where ever the need for those staff to move to, quite possibly.
Thank you. I don't think that's quite the question, but it's near enough. And I mean, I can see how you could have a situation, sorry to push in, Chair, a situation where you break everything up into specialties and allocate those specialties elsewhere. And that's the kind of scenario we're talking about, Dave, where you could have a little bit of bereft of any specialties, all specialities. Isolated over onto the Liverpool side or Chester or whatever, and that's quite a possibility, I'm sure. And when we get back to this, and I know we will get back to it, it will all be about implementation. It's had a broad view, it's confused us all, thank you very much, but it's all going to be about implementation and use of those resources locally and rural, and that's what we want to see the detail of.
Okay, thank you. Do we have any more questions? Normally at this part I'd say we just know the report, but we haven't really got one. But in summary, if I can suggest that we meet again post Thursday, because obviously we are coming up to election time, so what I also would remind members as well is that we have a spotlight session which will take place on the 21st, Wednesday, the 21st of February, when we'll have officers again from rural CCG to provide members with people who are coming early to care with you. Thank you.